Finally, let's have a look at the tricuspid valve. The best view is to go parasternal, and there are some patients that if you go from long axis view, to RV inflow, then you can have a nice view of the tricuspid valve. If you don't like this view, then you can go to short axis view, go to the level of the great arteries, and show the tricuspid valve on your view. Then you can press again for the zoom prepare. You can include the tricuspid valve, and then you press 4D, you can go with two-click crop, again from left ventricle, from right ventricle, sorry, to right atrium. We can remove some gain. And as you remember, the leaflets of the tricuspid valve are very thin, so I have to decrease the frame rate, increase my spatial resolution, and then I ask the patient to hold his breath. Κράτα αναπνοή. Acquire a multi-beat acquisition. Ανασένεις κανονικά. And then I go towards the valve. I can change my color, go to anatomy that I like it most. I always go and increase the gamma to have my a view more dark. And then you can see in this view that we have a nice image of the tricuspid valve live with all three leaflets. And what leaflet is what? The leaflet that is next to the septum, this one is the septal. Here is the aorta. Opposite to the aorta, the smallest leaflet is the posterior. And next to the aorta, this large leaflet is the anterior leaflet. So this is the best way to acquire a nice tricuspid valve with 4D imaging. Thank you for watching.